In this video, let's understand the rates involved in banking system. So before going to that, we can see how is the banking system in India. So here, all the banks which is working in our country comes under RBI, that is Reserve Bank of India. So we all know that Reserve Bank of India is the head bank of India. Yes. So our banking system is classified into two. One is scheduled bank, another one is non-scheduled bank. Now we can see what is scheduled bank. The scheduled banks are those who satisfy the Banking Regulation Act 1965, and their working capital will be above 5 lakhs. And the non-scheduled bank does not fulfill the norms of Banking Regulation Act 1965. Also, their working capital will be less than 5 lakhs. So here, this scheduled bank is again classified into two. One is commercial bank, another one is cooperative bank. So here, the commercial banks are, one is public sector banks. The public sector banks like SBI or OBC, that is Oriental Bank of Commerce, and so on. Then we have private sector banks like ICICI, Axis, HDFC, and so on. Next is foreign banks like Standard Bank, Chartered Banks, etc. And this foreign bank should fulfill the norms of RBI as well as their host country. And we have regional rural banks. So this regional rural banks are established to reach out the people in rural areas. So this regional rural bank are the banks like Tamil Nadu Mercantile Bank, Kerala Grameen Bank, etc. And then comes the cooperative banks. So this cooperative banks are usually used to fund small businesses in our country. So this cooperative bank, it can be either state or district bank. So this is the banking system of India. So now let's understand the rates involved in banking system. So in our banking system, we have Reserve Bank of India, that is RBI. Then we have commercial banks and the customers. Yes. So here the customers will deposit some money in bank, and not all the amount goes to bank's pocket, okay, or bank's wallet. The bank should give some of the amount to RBI. So here there is a question that what is the exact amount that should be given by bank to RBI. So this amount is decided by CRR, that is cash reserve ratio. For example, if cash reserve ratio is 5% and the customer deposit rupees 1000 in bank, that is in 1000 5%, that is 50 rupees goes to RBI and the remaining amount goes to bank's wallet. So here the bank will think to earn money out of it. So how will the bank earn money? The bank will earn money by issuing loans to the public, and thereby the bank will earn profit in few months. So here just assume that the bank has given the full amount as a loan to another customer. Okay, full amount in the sense the whole 950 the bank has given as a loan to another customer. So suddenly if a deposit customer asks for his money back, where will the bank go for money? So to overcome this type of situation, the bank could not give up all their deposited money as a loan. The bank have to invest some of the deposited money in liquid assets. So what is this liquid asset? This liquid asset, it can be either government bonds or gold and so on. Okay, so what is the exact amount to be invested in the liquid assets? That is decided by SLR, statutory liquidity ratio. So if suppose the SLR is 20%, so the 20% of the deposited amount of which bank has should be invested in the liquid assets. Okay, and then the remaining amount can be used by the bank for their daily expenses or for giving away the loans to the customers. And suppose if the deposited customer has their money, what can the bank do? The bank can sell the liquidity asset to RBI and get money, and that money can be given to the deposited customers. Now Just consider the situation where the bank do not have any sufficient amount to meet its daily expenses or to give away loans to the customers, etc. Okay, so here in this situation, what will the bank do for money? So automatically the bank will approach the RBI for some money as a loan. Okay, so this RBI will agrees to give money as a loan, but at a certain rate of interest. So that rate of interest is called repo rate. So this loan from RBI can be short term or long term. The rate charged for short term loan is called repo rate, and the rate charged for long term loan is called bank rate. Okay. So here now, if the RBI decides to increase the repo rate, automatically the rate of loan from bank to customer also increases. Whereas if the RBI decides to decrease the repo rate, then the rate of loan from bank to customer is also decreased. And hence, by controlling the repo rate, the RBI can control the money in the economy. Now consider another scenario. Suppose if bank have excess money and the bank decides to deposit some of the money to RBI. So in return, the RBI pays some of the rate of interest to the bank, and that rate of interest is called reverse repo rate. So these are some of the important rates that we should know in the banking system. So what are the rates we saw in this video? One is cash reserve ratio, that is CRR. Next one is SLR, statutory liquidity ratio. Next is repo rate. Next is reverse repo rate.